Welcome back to another bee swarm simulator test run video. Today what I'm going to be doing is I am going to be using a hive full of level 20 gifted tadpole bees. So yeah, like all the other videos, first thing I gotta do, claim badges, get all the items. And then I'm gonna do this pretty quick. I'm just gonna star egg my hive and I'll get back to you guys when I'm done with that. And now we are done with that. So I just quickly instant converted all my pollen at the instant converter. And now we're gonna use the red cannon to get up to the 25 B zone, and we're gonna get everything in the red shop, except for obviously the golden rake and the spark staff, because they're not gonna be helpful at all. In fact, you know what? While we're in here, we don't really need to get the porcelain dipper, do we? Like if we go here, we need the glider, we need the porcelain porter hive. We're not gonna need the porcelain dipper, but we're gonna need everything else real quick. Anyway, now that we're done with that, we can get started on filling our hive with the tadpole bees. So yeah, I'll get back to you guys when I'm done with that. Oh my god, finally I'm done with that. That actually took ages. Oh my god, that was so painful. Anyway, so I'm just gonna quickly get the buffs. I'm gonna make my hive level 20 and gifted. That's always so satisfying. I'm gonna quickly get test realm mega boost. And then I need to get some amulets, so I need to quickly get a good SSA. Okay, so yeah, we've got all the amulets set up. There's so much baby, there's like constant baby love because all my tadpole bees are gifted. Anyway, so now what we wanna do is we want to get the, I can't speak, we want to get all our equipment. First thing we're gonna wanna do, we're gonna get the tide popper since this is gonna be a blue hive. Then mask, we're gonna need to go to the blue HQ, so I'm just gonna. Okay, so now we're at the diamond mask parkour, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna quickly scroll up through my inventory. Where is it? There, night bell. We're gonna use this. It's gonna instantly become nighttime. And we're gonna not mess up the parkour like we did last time. Jesus, wait, I actually did that first try. I'm crazy. Okay, so we're gonna get the diamond mask. Okay, so we got mask fully set up. Oh my god, I went back through the parkour as well. Anyway, so now what do we need to do? We need to get the gummy boots. I'm gonna transition to the gummy store. Let's get it. And would you look at that? I'm in the gummy shop now. So like I said, I just need to quickly get the gummy boots and then, no, I'm not gonna reset, I'm gonna whirligig. Just whirligig out of here, get all the way back to the hive. And now we need to get the crimson and cobalt god, so I'm just gonna quickly. So we're just gonna quickly get this, go over here, and get this. Okay, now we are almost fully set up, we just need the coconut canister. And to get the coconut canister, we have to beat the coconut crab. Which, in case you don't know, is going to be very hard because if you go down here and you look at the tadpole bee's stats, it has 0.5 attack, which makes it one of the weakest bees in the game. I'm pretty sure it's actually the second weakest bee in the game when it comes to attack. The baby bee doesn't do any damage, but the tadpole bee, at least it does damage. Okay, so we're just going to pop a stinger and we're going to go into coconut field. Okay, let's see how long this is going to take. Oh my god, they're doing like no damage. And they're slow as well, so they can't catch up to him. Look at how slow they are. I'm just gonna summon some frogs. Oh my god, that is a lot of frogs. Oh, I'm just taking damage. Look at all these frogs. Oh my, they've already gone to sleep. What is this? Why are they so weak? Okay, there, finally. That took so long. Baby bees are so bad at fighting. Oh my god. Anyway, so we're just gonna quickly get the coconut canister. And there, we're fully set up to test out the farming potential of the tadpole bees. We were already testing out a bit here because of all these bubbles and frogs. Anyway, what I want to do is I want to test this out in the pine tree forest, like we did with the buoyant bee video. So what I'm gonna do is, like the buoyant bee video, I'm going to boost up the pine tree forest. Except I'm not gonna make the mistake of not using a super smoothie this time. I already have a super smoothie set up to make sure I don't make that mistake again. So what I'm going to do is I'm just gonna quickly go up to the loaded dice and get myself no pine tree boosts. Okay, there. We got a pine tree boost, and I'm gonna use a glitter. And then we get a 4x pine tree boost. And then time to just summon a bunch of frogs and see just how many bubbles and stuff we can get. The thing with tadpole bees, oh, we got the diamond mask passive. The thing with tadpole bees is you're always gonna have baby love active if you have a hive full of them. Because no, a hive full of gifted tadpole bees. Because gifted tadpole bees can summon baby love tokens, so you're just gonna get a lot of them if you have 50 gifted tadpole bees. But look at all of this pollen I'm getting. Look, my store, I'm getting like 80 million pollen per second. Oh my god, these bubbles are so OP. Wait, I'm actually gonna need to equip a micro converter. This is crazy. Wait. I'm gonna maximize this even more by doing this. We micro convert and we turn auto coconuts on. And I'm also gonna do the tab out trick so that my mouse will hold down left click without me having to press anything. Look at this! There's so many bubbles and so many frogs. And the thing is, the frogs actually collect tokens, so if there are any frog tokens appearing, the frogs will collect those frog tokens, which will make more frogs. And that'll make even more bubbles. Oh my god, my backpack's filling up so fast. Look at this, I'm averaging like 400 million honey per second. And like 100 million pollen per second. So I'm getting a crazy amount of instant conversion from the bubbles. This is actually insane. Look at all of these bubbles. This is why blue hives are so overpowered in the regular game for pollen farming. Like, look at how fast I'm getting pollen. Look at this. This is crazy. And then look, my tidal waves are so stacked up. Look at how high they go. My tidal waves are so powerful now because of all the bubbles I've collected. And the tidal waves also pop bubbles if they go through them, so like it pops even more bubbles, increasing the power of the tidal waves, making them even stronger. It's kind of just like a loop. It's kind of just like a loop that keeps on getting stronger. Like, you get the tidal waves from popping the bubbles, and the tidal waves pop bubbles. So, when you pop the bubbles with the tidal waves, it'll make the tidal waves stronger so they can pop bubbles better and get more pollen. It just keeps on repeating the process until, like, you get a crazy amount of pollen and honey from this. Look at all of that. Look at all of that pollen. Oh my god. This is actually insane. Look at the tide power stat. That inc we almost got double tool speed, which means we're gonna send tidal waves in faster. Oh my god, it's going so fast now. Look at how big the tidal waves are getting as well. Oh my god. if you're gonna use the tadpole for farming, you just have to have the, you just have to have a bunch of tadpole bees. That's just out of the question. You have to, because they're gonna make your tide power so strong. Oh my god! This is actually crazy. And I get coconut haste from that. This, oh my god. And look at this tide power stack. Tool speed is drastically increasing because of all the bubbles. Okay, I feel like I've demonstrated just how powerful this is for farming. Yeah, I feel like I have well demonstrated the power of 50 gifted tadpole bees in farming. It is absolutely insane for making honey. And when you combo it with buoyant bees, where you can fill up the balloons insanely quick, that just makes farming pollen so easy. So, yeah, that's going to be it for today's video. If you enjoyed the video, please make sure to like and subscribe. It helps out with my channel a lot, and it helps me producing more test realm content. Also, if you have any ideas for experiments, for test realm experiments, please put them in the comments down below so I can use the ideas for making videos. I tried to use most of the ideas, but in the past, like, few weeks, my channel's been gaining, like, a lot of attention, so it's hard to do every idea. I probably won't be able to do every idea, but if I like your idea, I will definitely do it. So anyway, yeah, that's gonna be it for today's video. Like I said, if you enjoyed the video, please make sure to like and subscribe. Anyway, that's it. See you guys in the next video. Bye.